Tim fucking watches later. But yeah, Tim, he like, he was there, and he was talking about it. He was talking, I think he was like talking about his testimony, and his whole story with that, and it was like crazy. Because especially, he had a story about his daughter, where his daughter like had a seizure, and like the next day she was fine. I was like, that's insane. So I asked him some questions. I think it was like about hell, like, oh, how can innocent people like innocent kids go to hell? Because that's one of the things I was holding back at the time from like figuring out this God. I still didn't really know. So he was like, yeah. I was like, what does it take to be Christian? I think I messaged him on Facebook. He was like, I'm curious about this. I'm curious about faith. And what do I need to know? So he sent me a bunch of videos, and I watched like 10 seconds of it, and then I got bored. I didn't reply. And what's really interesting is that I feel like God kind of is like, hey, come this way. And then you do more of it, and it really says, hey, come here. And so, yeah, that happened. Because in senior year, like, I was just super, just like, I don't know, I was kind of antisocial in a way. I hated high school the whole time. I wanted to get out. College, like, I felt like I wasn't prepared for college at all because I was gone the whole summer. I came back and I was like, I hate school. And I really still can tell you that I hate school. Honestly. But, yeah. I was like in such a dark place. And I still had like, I was still a good person, but all these thoughts in my head, they were just dark. It was like really disturbing. I was like, this isn't me. I remember sitting in my car one night and I was like, man. I was just like, I was so deep into it, and all this thought, and all these actions, and I was like, yeah, don't worry, I'm not a criminal, okay? I got like three background checks, and I'm a good person, so don't worry. Just take my word for it. So, I was like sitting in my car, I was like, man, I just hate who I'm becoming. Like, this is so horrible. And all these thoughts in my head, like, they're just so dark, and I felt like, I kind of just stopped thinking about them as dark. I felt like they were just thoughts passing through my head. And I was like, man, this isn't me. Like, I love my family. I'm like a good person. I love my parents. My dad's in my life. I'm thankful for that. And my girlfriend at the time, I didn't tell her, but I was like, hey, can I come to church with you? And she's like, yeah, of course. And previous to that, this is freshman year of college. No, sophomore year. This is just recently, like last semester. Over the summer, I had this like super crazy dream. And that was after everything happened. And I had this crazy dream that was like, I felt like I was at a gate and it was all golden and crazy. And just before that, in the dream, my dad was showing me the Bible. And I looked into the Bible and I like got sucked into this hole. And then I was like staring up and I just saw this gate. And it was scary. Like, it was so scary. And I thought I saw a face or something, but it was frightening. Like, I woke up and I felt like I needed to get to know God. And the crazy thing is I've had insane dreams, like, but never a dream that I woke up feeling like I needed to know God. And so I went to church and I heard one of the songs. I think it was like resurrection for me. And I just started like crying. And I don't even know why. I didn't even know what the words were saying. And I was like standing in the back row. And I was just like, they're like, please stand. And I just stood up. I didn't know what was going on. I just started crying because I felt like warm. I felt this impression on me. And yeah, I didn't really tell anyone. But I talked to my friend about it because she knew Tim. And I didn't really want to go to Tim first because I just, like, ignored him after all those years, right? This is 3 years later, guys. 3-4 years later. And I had just ignored the guy. I felt bad. So, I talked to my friend Rebecca again. And she was like, hey, that's really awesome. First, you should talk to your dad about it. So, like, yeah, I called my dad. He was like, yeah, son, that's awesome. Like, your grandmother has really strong prayers to you. Like, can't go wrong with faith. There's nothing wrong with having faith. That was super reassuring because I wasn't sure how I would feel about it. And the other thing Rebecca told me was, oh, you should just go join campus ministry. So I was like, oh, yeah, I'll look into that. I was walking like right here and I saw the pulse table like 2 days after or something, or a few days after, and like Noelle, or Noelle here, and she's like, hi! Telling his story again, and he was like, if you feel like you're in a place where you just need to, like, surrender. And up until that point, I just been trying to be so self-sufficient, because that's how I was raised, right? A very strong person. And just to be like, you can handle things on your own. But, and I didn't come in with intentions to, like, just be like, oh, surrender and everything. But when I was just standing, and he said, if you feel like you're in a place where you need to do that, would you just stand? And I just felt like I had to stand up. Because I had to acknowledge all the things that had happened to that point. And I just stood up and prayed. And in that point, like, I think that marks the beginning of my urban knowing Christ. And it has grown me so much because, like, just I've been growing in so many ways. Like, I had anger problems, and it's just gone. Like, It's really, I feel like I'm just new. And all those issues before, those like dark thoughts or whatever, just like, oh, the world's gonna end or something. I feel like the world's ending. All those things are just gone. And it really, like, I kind of like find peace in that. And I'm so thankful that like I followed God's call and that He was there for me, which is, it's like one of the greatest feelings ever. Yeah, so I've been growing a pulse. I started going to Campbell. I've been growing there. I hate Christian music, but I love it now. Thank you.